was born, my papa's son, when I hit the ground, I was on my run.
I remember being in school out in Arizona, and they'd be making fun of my accent. And next thing they knew, I had their lunch money. John Boehner was crying at a Taco Bell event. But you know what? I'm going to take up for John Boehner. I'm telling you, a spicy chalupa can mess a man up. Make it walk funny. And welcome to Intellectual Frog Legs. You know, unlike Boehner and McConnell and McCain and Graham and all the other rhinos that have infested the Republican Party, we actually have some men of integrity in our legislative branch.
Can you imagine a fact pattern where somebody takes the stand and says, I didn't rob the bank, but I'm not going to answer why my fingerprints are on the demand note, and I'm not going to tell you why I'm on the surveillance footage with the gun in my hand, and I'm not going to tell you why the dye pack blew up in my car. I'm just going to tell you I didn't rob the bank. The same Constitution that allows her the right, if she wants to sit there and say nothing, allows these groups the right to petition their government for redress.
Men that are actually standing up for the rule of law, something that's been missing the last few years. And you know what? They're not getting any love in the media. We need to let them know that we support them. Email them, call their office. Life ain't no spectator sport, and freedom has to be defended. But you know what? This guy articulated a little bit better.
Freedom is never more than one generation away from extinction. We didn't pass it on to our children in the bloodstream. The only way they can inherit the freedom we have known is if we fight for it, protect it, defend it, and then hand it to them with the well-taught lessons of how they in their lifetime must do the same. And if you and I don't do this, then you and I may well spend our sunset years telling our children and our children's children what it once was like in America when men were free.
And here's a guy most people don't even know, another Texan, Blake Farenthal. And this dude, he destroyed Eric Holder. He refused to participate in questioning of the Attorney General, saying Holder should be in jail.
I don't think we should be... Mr. Holder should be here. He's in contempt of this body. I've called for his resignation. I've sponsored articles of impeachment. And this week I'm going to be introducing legislation that would prevent federal employees who are held in contempt of Congress or who fail to fully comply with congressional subpoenas not be paid their taxpayer-funded salary. And I just don't think it's appropriate that Mr. Holder be here if an American citizen had not complied with one of the Justice Department subpoenas, they would be in jail, not sitting here in front of testifying.
I don't know.
And right here, this picture right here tells you why people respect Ted Cruz. And what's that old saying? These are the times that try men's souls. We're getting to a boiling point in this country. Cool heads need to prevail. The citizens are upset, and the federal government has gone insane. They are power crazed everywhere, from coast to coast. And there's so much red tape and bureaucracies. It's like we have governments within governments. I mean, like, what was once a drip, drip, drip of socialism is now a full-throttled faucet of communism. Free speech areas? First Amendment areas? The whole United States is a First Amendment area, jackasses. I'm sick of this. And this Bundy Ranch stuff, it could have been avoided. You got a law-abiding rancher running a 140-year-old family business, ranching, lawfully using and investing in the same county land going back to the 1800s. 20 years ago, the federal government comes in, They don't negotiate. They don't buy it. They seize this land, and then they change the rules, and they turn a law-abiding citizen into a federal criminal. All in the name of allegedly saving a friggin' turtle, which is a lie. But, and there's a lot of green energy shenanigans going on, too.
Living in the wild, wild west. The wild, wild west. The wild, wild west.
You know what? Let's pretend just for a minute that the feds actually do have jurisdiction to control how county-owned public land is used whenever they decide, and for whatever reasons they dictate. Oh, and by the way, if a federal agency claims ownership of your property, you do have recourse. You can sue this federal agency in federal court. Yeah, talk to my cousin. He'll work it out for you. That's a square deal, Wally. Anyway, back on point. If the feds did have this unlimited discretionary jurisdiction, the action they took was not just unnecessary, it was irrationally mental patient level excessive. I mean, these guys had multiple peaceful solutions. And keep in mind, this is allegedly over money, the grazing fees. You know, they could have frozen assets, frozen accounts. You know, the most common remedy in a case like this is filing a judgment on the person's property. But that's not what they did. They chose brute force. This was important as hell to somebody.
Well, it's not over.
And I think it's safe to say it was not about those grazing fees. Armed agents, canine units, snipers against American citizens? Can you imagine if they've actually protected our border like that? And I guess the brown shirts are just a coincidence, huh? Hold on. Making sure I'm in the proper First Amendment zone here.
The government didn't create us. We, the people, create the government. And at any moment, we have the right to alter or abolish it. And we're about to alter it.
I'm moving right now, one dark and windy day. A potter edge, he rested as we went along his way. Their brands are still on fire and their hooves are made of steel. Their horns are black and shiny and their heart breath he can feel. The bolts are tearing through him as they thunder through the sky. Saw the riders coming hard. Heard their mournful cry.
But what law enforcement agency was that? The Bureau of Land Management. That's a law enforcement agency? I used to think they were just like a handful. You know, like, well, we had the local police, the county sheriff, state police, FBI, CIA, maybe a couple more or something. Turns out there's like 70 law enforcement agencies. Federal. Federal law enforcement agencies. Which means they can carry a gun and a badge and arrest you. Don't forget, last year the EPA used a SWAT team. Why does the EPA have a SWAT team? They're in the Environmental Protection Agency. Anyway, the EPA used a SWAT team to raid a small mining operation in Chicken, Alaska for allegedly violating the Clean Water Act. Sending in 8 armed agents in a city that only has a population of 7. Are you kidding? This is beyond rational thought. And don't forget that, you know, they remember the feds raided Gibson guitars with their SWAT gear and all this for, I guess they thought Gibson was wood terrorists. I wonder how many Obama supporting companies have actually been harassed like this by the feds.
can't have an American people that violate the law and just walk away from it. So it's not over.
You're a legend in your own mind.
You know what, this has been going on. Back in 2001, the Department of Interior cut off Klamath River access to Oregon farmers during a drought in order to maintain the water levels for the fish covered under the Endangered Species Act. Really? I mean, this is so insane. So look, just remember, when Al-Qaeda hits us again, remember our government was watching me and you.
I'm telling you, you're going to see an uprising in this nation. And it won't be long now. I mean, you just can't keep pushing, folks.
Bill of Rights has been shredded. You know what? America's fed up. We're fed up. You know what? I remember in the late 70s, I was a teenager, and I kept hearing all the doom and gloom talk about America being over. The presidency was too big for just one man. And I remember being scared then, too. Things couldn't get much worse. We had gas lines, rationing of gas, you know, even numbered license plates on one day, odd numbers the next day. We had ridiculous interest rates. We had the Iranian hostage crisis. I mean, it was a dark, dark time. The country's morale was in the dumper. And then we got Ronald Reagan. So we've done this before. We just got to do it again. Now get off your asses and let's go.
Revolution will not be televised.
White folk getting ready to rise up. They don't want to take it no more. And I'm joining them. Oh, doggone it. I am. She's coming down.
You know, one last say on this Bundy Ranch thing. This was historic. I think it's going to go down as when America started fighting back. When the citizens started fighting back against their government. You know, America, you know what? America's not the government. America is the people. The thing about this Bundy Ranch thing is, number one, it beautifully demonstrated the intent of the Second Amendment without a shot being fired. Not a single shot. And that's why the media and these left-wing freaks, if they're not completely ignoring it, they're twisting it into something it's not. They're trying to portray Cliven Bundy as some unlawful deadbeat who doesn't pay his bills. But that's what they do. You gotta forget what they do. We gotta focus on what we can do. But now, I ain't gonna lie. When I heard that we had armed militia from all over the country swarming onto the Bundy Ranch, ooh, I was having a kind of a bad feeling. But God bless them. God bless them. They showed cool heads, they were organized, and they shattered the left-wing stereotype. They were not some trigger-happy hillbillies with a couple of shotguns ready to shoot anything that moves. Mm-mm. These are some serious men. They were there to defend freedom, and that is exactly what they did. More importantly, it demonstrated Reagan's philosophy of peace through strength. Before the militia showed up, what were the feds doing? What were they doing? They were bullying. They were tasing citizens, sticking dogs on them, knocking women down. They had snipers scoping American citizens. But they didn't do that when the militia was there, did they? Peace through strength. Now, I encourage everybody to pray that cool heads prevail. Because nobody wants to see anybody get hurt.
When nonviolent resistance means that you do resist in a very strong and determined manner.
Well, you know what? When you have a government that sends in armed forces over cattle grazing fees, the problem is not the citizens.
And here I go again on my own.
And then you got Harry Reid and his son Rory Reid. Ridiculous. The hell's a Rory? Isn't that what a gay lion does? Rory. Anyway, enough of that nonsense. You know what? Just because government says something is legal does not make it right. And stealing is stealing. We've got World War III brewing. We've got a president that's a mental patient who shouldn't be in charge of a convenience store. Obama warned Putin again. He warned him. My gosh! We're going to cancel your Netflix account this time, buddy. And you know what? This IRS thing is so far beyond a scandal. I mean, you got emails showing collusion between Democrat congressmen, Obama's Department of Justice, and the IRS for the specific purpose of targeting political opponents, Tea Partiers, conservatives, Republicans. And if we don't do something now, it's over. If we don't stand for liberty now, it's over. The November election is the most important date you should have on your calendar. And until then, preparing for it should be job number one.
Papa got a brand new bag.
This is Branko from Comically Incorrect, and you're watching Intellectual Froglegs.
My goodness, the Mexican army. It comes into the United States, holds our U.S. Border Patrol at gunpoint, and our government does nothing? But then they turn guns on American citizens over cattle illegal grazing? Again, who's been right about every bit of this? The Tea Party. So you need to quit mocking them and pay attention because you might learn something. The Tea Party's not trying to take anything from you. They're not trying to force you to do anything. And they're not just fighting for their freedom, they're fighting for your freedom, for your children's freedom. My God, are you that brainwashed? Guys, go volunteer at True the Vote, because we can no longer leave election integrity in the hands of crooked government officials. And don't forget, May 16th in Washington, D.C., Operation American Spring. We got work to do.
Anybody knew, and knew more than me or you, no one could see a view. Oh, well, I'd be going through, and he tried, but before he could tell us he died, when he left us the people cried. Well, what's he going through? Oh!
One of these days, these boots are gonna walk all over you.
Thank you guys so much for being here. Please stop by the website, intellectualfroglegs.com. Join me on Facebook and Twitter, and thank you for the awesome donations. Dig those. Froglegs are free to watch, but they're not free to make. And for you guys that are too broke to donate, well, we're probably cousins. By the way, the Founders Club fundraiser is still going on, and you can be a member of the Founders Club for as little as $5. $5. I'm not going to do it again. Please share the show with your friends and share it with some Democrat voters, because we got to get the word out. And what could Obama possibly use to scare Putin?
Government is the problem.